The timeline of the Las Vegas massacre. Police now say the killer shot a hotel security guard 6 minutes before he began shooting at concert goers from his window, not after, as they'd originally thought. So let's discuss with CNN law enforcement, both of you. So this is an interesting development, okay? James, let me pull up for everybody the timeline as we now know it, as the authorities have.
My view of it is this. Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department perspective is the messaging, the information they're giving out. And initially, there were a number of press conferences that the sheriff of the Las Vegas.
They shouldn't be theorizing in public.
I would like to see.
There's so, I mean, the guy's dead. Maybe they should be forthcoming about information.
There's not going to be a court.
That they are following. They've spoken to his brother again. They've spoken to his longtime girlfriend. We understand that he was prescribed a drug, Valium, for anxiety. Where are you with trying to piece together this puzzle?
As more and more information as this, is it speaks to motive. It speaks to the mechanisms and method. Get some drills in there. And were those drills potentially to put pinhole cameras in? Could we know?
Very Thank much. You. Chris.
Republicans.
Wildfires throughout the program since those are continuing at this hour and firefighters are battling them. But good morning, everyone. Welcome to your new day. The feud between President Trump and Senator Bob Corker is escalating as Senate Republicans, for the most part, stay silent. A White House official tells CNN that the president is not finished with Corker. Meanwhile, we're hearing Senator Corker tell a New York Times reporter that the president's volatility is, quote, alarming, and he's questioning the president's fitness to hold office. Hillary Clinton and former President Barack Obama staying silent. President Trump and Senator Bob Corker's war of words continues. A White House official tells CNN that President Trump is not finished with Senator Corker. Let's discuss all of this. Foreign Relations Committee, which Senator Corker chairs. Great to have you here.
Thanks,
Senator,
Allison.
In studio. What do you think of Senator Corker so publicly criticizing President Trump?
Bob, they're not.
He's the one who's publicly saying it, but nobody else is rising to defend him or have his back.
Not yet, although if you look at over saying on the Republican side.
I know you want to talk about the Puerto Rico relief effort, and we're going to get there in a second.
Yep.
But first, in terms of Harvey Weinstein, obviously Hollywood.
Or low-life behavior. They're
grotesque.
Just, they're unacceptable.
He gave, I think, $39,000 to yours and Hillary Clinton's 2016 election effort. Should that money be given back?
Well, the campaign's over, and whether it's in government or media, it's
spent.
Over.
It can't be given back.
Yeah, it's over.
Hillary Clinton spoke for 90 minutes last night in California, but she didn't mention Harvey Weinstein. Why not?
Look, you know, investment often, and I'm sure she'll have a word to. So
you just returned. You've just returned from there. When you came back, you tweeted this. Was in Puerto Rico Saturday, only 15%.
Virginia. Part of the state's hit badly, but other parts not so badly, so people can go to other places. Well, it's the federal government, it's other helping them get their grid back up.
Who are you calling on to do more today?
Well,
I mean, everyone there is in dire straits. I don't know how they're going to get back to work. I don't know how they're going to rebuild. But you're saying that if the president asked for more billions, that Congress would authorize, giving him enough credit. He tweeted this. Nobody could have done.
You know, it was kind of joking around or kind of a game rather than a seriousness that you would expect.
That Puerto Rico is with you, Carmen Julian Cruz has been, as you know, quite outspoken, and she's gotten a bit of a smackdown from FEMA. I mean, who have said we filter that out? That's noise, what she's saying. But she's the person making the really emotional entreaty for more help. So why do you think that FEMA is kind of trying to?
Well, look,
their president has been doing a great job. I mean, he's not begging for more.
Yeah, but I can run a generator forever. You can't run a nursing home on. And our response for these American citizens should match the gravity of what he's dealing with.
Senator Tim Kaine, great to talk to you. Thanks for being
Allison.
Here in studio. Let's get over to Chris.
All right.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to your new day. Chris is off this morning, and Bill Weir joins me. Great to have you
Good
here.
Good to be with you, my friend.
It's a busy holiday.
It is,
so
it
let's
is.
Get right to it. President Trump's escalating feud with a top Republican intensifying today. Senator Bob Corker now says the president is treating the White House like, quote, a reality show, and his reckless threats could put the nation on the path to World War III.
Meanwhile,
minutes ago, President Trump tweeted about Vice President Mike Pence's very public exit from the Colts 49ers game in Indianapolis. The president to open fire on thousands of people at the country music festival in Las Vegas last week. Movie mogul Harvey Weinstein fired from his the studio that bears his name amid allegations of sexual harassment. The revelations come in a New York Times expose that reveals decades of settlements with at least 8 women. Joining us now is CNN senior
Weinstein. He was always a volatile
with Fox. The settlements and the non-disclosures make it impossible legally for the women to come forward. And he's so powerful. Now the women say, you know, he was a rainmaker. They didn't want him to ruin their careers. I mean, this is how it works. You know, absolute power corrupts absolutely.
Lisa Bloom, for example, one of his lawyers, had a
Sharon who tried to write about this for the New York Times in 2004, and only now are we all talking about it. So is this a tipping point?
I would say the work a decade ago. Others were trying to do this reporting a decade ago. In the case of Fox News and
about some good stuff.
The good stuff?
Let's do that next.
All right.
Stick around.